Have you ever accepted a challenge and thought,
this is way too easy?
So you didn't prepare? Hi, I'm David Alexander, and I wanted to share with you what it took for me and my friend James Ryan to design and throw a paper airplane more than 100 feet. Spoiler alert, we failed so many times, it was actually embarrassing. Here's the story. NASA challenged us to come up with a fun aeronautics-related activity where students design and throw a paper airplane 100 feet or farther. So we accepted the challenge thinking, what's the big deal? We fold a few planes, those planes will easily fly 100 feet, maybe even 200 feet, and we'll knock this out in one or two tries. Easy, right? We were so wrong. None of our paper airplanes even came close to 100 feet. Our designs vary greatly, and we threw each plane with all our strength, but the farthest we could reach was 62 feet. Yes, we took the challenge for granted, but maybe we could still pull this off. Our biggest problem was we couldn't figure out what went wrong, and we needed help. We thought, what would an engineer do? We recall the very first step in the engineering design process is to ask questions. So my friend James contacted an aerospace engineer at NASA named Jesse Quinlan. So here's what Jesse said.
Hi, Jesse, how are you?
I'm doing well, James. How are you doing?
I need help. Like, I don't know what I'm doing wrong.
Sure, James. Yeah, I'm glad you reached out. At NASA, we actually think about what it takes to make a great airplane a lot. You know, we care about the world around us, and we believe in a sustainable future for aviation. So it's important for us to always be working toward aircraft concepts and designs that support this vision. And it's important in your case, you have a very small paper airplane. We need to minimize the drag however we can. And my first tip to you, just make those folds as tight as you possibly can, and especially the leading edge of your wings. So the frontmost surfaces of your wings, make sure those are nice and crisp, and I think we'll be able to reduce your drag a little bit and help us fly a little bit further. Maybe the most important tip I can give you here is related to stability. We want our CG, or our center of gravity, to be a little bit more forward than our aerodynamic center. So if you maybe have a paper clip or some tape, you could apply that to the nose. That'll help ensure that your nose wants to tend down instead of tending up, because what happens when your nose pitches up, you run the risk of stalling and dropping out of the sky like a brick. The one other thing that I'll say about this too is I don't think I saw any dihedral on your aircraft. Angle this wing up, exactly. Hold that wingtip and just angle it up a little bit so that the wingtips are higher than the root, exactly, just like that. What that's gonna do is it's gonna make the aircraft have a tendency to roll stabilize itself. And so I think with those few really important considerations, you can probably achieve the paper airplane range of your dreams. So I wish you the best of luck, and I hope for many successful flights in your future, James.
Jesse's tips were exactly what we needed. Now, do you think the ways that NASA optimizes flight and makes aircraft more sustainable can help our paper airplane go the distance? There's only one way to find out. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, the moment of truth. We're actually going to find out how far of a distance he threw a paper airplane.
Feet. We finally got it to go past 100 feet.
I'm so excited.
When we saw that paper airplane reach 102 feet, it was electrifying. When those sustainability principles were put to the test, they really worked. So we included them in an activity called Wingin' It. Maybe you can beat our record of 102 feet.
102 feet. We did it. So many tries, so many attempts, so many failures. But you know what? That was okay. Because we learned so much from our failures.